Wagwan, good people! It's the Midnight Hump Show. Thank you so much for tuning in from all around the world. It's about to get crazy with...
It is BarakJacuzzi, the Coco Master.
My name is Sheryl, the hero, what a Guan Black!
It's your girl, LED Zone.
Wagwan, good people, on today's show we have What's Good's very own Kalinga and BK co-hosting. And coming through for Bless the Mic is King Shukid. This is the Midnight Hump Show. Women and gentlemen of the world,
welcome
to the Midnight Hump Show. I'm BarakJacuzzi, the Coco Master, the Pretty Roster, Mr. Oya, Mr. Sevenini dropping tonight.
What was the long introduction though? Yo, my name is BarakJacuzzi, the KBK.
My name is Njeri, but on the internet they call me Cheesy Ricky.
Cheesy Ricky.
My name's Louis Kalinga, a.k.a. Lingo.
And this is the Midnight Hump Show. You know, Cheryl the Hero couldn't be here today.
Shout out to LED.
She's out the country. Just a lot going on, man. But, you know, my partner, my player partners are hitting here building to hold it down.
You know we got you.
And usually I'm outnumbered to women on the show. So, Njeri,
we're taking over.
Shout out to being the minority today. It's a man's world. Get your estrogen levels up.
Ooh.
Because you're outnumbered. You're outnumbered right now. Hey, how y'all feeling though, man? Tell me.
Feeling good, man.
See you guys, you know?
It's Wednesday, I mean, Friday.
Oh. Yeah, what's going on, man? You got some days left, man.
Relax,
man. Hey, and DJ Echo, man, my bad,
what's
dog.
Up,
my bad.
Up.
You know you over here just playing this.
You know I was waiting for my mom, man.
My bad, dog. They distracted me, man. I got distracted by these guys. Yo, DJ Echo, what's good? How you feeling, man?
I'm feeling good. I'm honored to be here.
Hey, it's an honor to have you. It's an honor to have you. Yeah, we've been jamming out.
On the drop, King,
yeah?
Yeah. Where can people find any, do you put any mixes out on SoundCloud?
Okay. You can find me on SoundCloud as DJ Echo.
DJ Echo.
That is E-C-H-O-E.
Okay.
You can find me on Facebook, Echo. Trapped in Nairobi.
For sure.
Yeah, you can follow me on Instagram too.
For sure. DJ Echo, right?
Yeah, no.
More jewels. Okay, more jewels. Keep it all the same, Echo. Now, it's the Midnight Hump Show. We got a lot to address today.
What's going on tonight?
First, we got to do the shout outs. You know, we got to see what's popping in the streets.
The loyal fans.
The good fans.
I got some ghetto shout outs I'm going to do because people, because I don't know where we get these shout outs, but I've been getting
the
people.
First one, though.
Okay, do the first one.
All right, big shout out to Duncan Wangeshe.
Dan Wangeshi, yay! Riba!
Shout out.
Did you just baptize him, Duncan?
Yeah, what was that?
I was like, give you the name Duncan.
His name is Dan.
It was Dan. Short form of Duncan.
It can be Dan's son.
No. You know,
yeah.
Daniel.
It can be a lot, bro. You tripping, man. No disrespect, Dan. He's going to come in like, man.
Put some respect when you mention my name.
Hey, shout out to Franklin Mwenda. Wagwan, G. Franklin Mwenda. How's it going, man? Modules? Oh, yeah.
Shout out Kelvin Mokoya.
This guy's loyal. Hey, Kelvin, man.
Kelvin is loyal.
I was about to say, I see him.
Yeah, he's been here for a while.
I think the last time I'm actually the one who mentioned his name as well.
Yeah. Shout out Kelvin Mokoya, man. You got to start getting like Midnight Hump Show like points. You know what I'm saying? Like,
we should actually start Midnight Hump Show.
Get to the finals.
Mokoya.
Hey.
Shout out to Dave Mtai and Vocanilla Techno.
Vocanilla Techno. How come there's always like an exotic name at the end?
Yeah, there's always something going on.
I could have sworn last week. Yo, I could have sworn we had Carlos Raul last week. And I was like, Carlos? Is he in Brazil? What's going on? Hey, and ghetto shout out. You know, I just got a DM. My DM's been popping this week. I don't know what's going on. It must be the hair. It must be the cocos. It must be the modules.
The coccicles.
But nah, it might be the coccicles. But shout out to Latima Fahima.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's
Latima Fahima. Yeah. She's Sudanese and, she's Somali and, Tanzania. I don't know.
Damn.
But anyway, she slid
picture,
in my DMs. Shout out to her. She says she likes the Midnight Hump Show. She thinks it's dope. So shout out to her.
Shout out.
Oh, yeah.
Much love, man.
But apart from big ups and shout outs.
What else we got?
It's time for some Ratchet News.
Ooh.
You know, I live on World Star. I love Ratchet News.
Yeah, a lot has been going down, bro.
And I'm really starting to fall in love with all the ratchetness that's happening.
Shout out the Ratchets, man.
Yeah, you guys keep us going. They do. Oh. Let's hit it with the first one. Hit them with the
Who that?
Nah, this is Party Next Door, but
ooh, yeah.
Party We weren't supposed to start with Party, but we can. You guys hear about Kylie and
Tyga
getting back together? Yeah. What do you guys think about it?
Is that true? Is it real?
That's what I heard. I mean, I don't know. Okay. I don't
what,
know.
What the internet is saying, Tyga said he's going back to. There's a quote that said, he told the paparazzi that I will always love Kylie.
That's so what he said. He called back.
Tyga be playing Kylie, with some.
And then you'd be crawling back.
Who in Hollywood is not playing?
Yeah, man, Tyga been going to France, but then it was spotted last with one of the...
Pull up Kylie. Pull up a picture of Kylie. Yeah, you see.
Yeah. But, yeah. Homeboy, man.
I mean, Kylie...
And she looks like she's 30 and he's Tyga, 19.
But I don't know, man. Tyga, I hope he does. You know, Kylie, she got lipstick. She got a lip cosmetic line out.
Everybody's ranting about that, actually.
But the thing I'm trying to understand is, I can't get no lip cosmetics from some new lip girl. She just got these, dude. Come on. I'm going to need her to, I'm going to need to see some lip verification.
Yeah. She's killing it.
Before she starts selling products. I need to see her. I ain't never seen her whistle. I ain't never seen Kylie
chew.
Eat a piece of ice. Whoa.
That's what he said. That he liked
it. No, because your lips get numb, bro. Come on, DK. You're disgusting. You're disgusting. You are disgusting. You disgust me. But let's pull up the picture with Party Next Door.
Yeah.
Because Party, you just saw he was in her she was in his new video.
Yeah, I saw the video. Yeah,
they were making out in the rain.
But guys said on the internet said Kyle was doing that with Party Next Door just to make Tyga jealous.
But he could also be thing. PND is doing it because of his girlfriend. What is her name?
Kalani.
Kalani.
But Party Next Door, man, he got light skin.
He's a lucky guy. He's a lucky guy.
Nah, he always slides. This is what he does. Party Next Door is the go-to rebound guy. He's the go-to rebound guy. With Kalani.
He cannot be known as the go-to.
He slid in there right after Kyrie. He's right there.
I wonder who he's getting next.
Man, he's OVO. He's OVO for sure. He's the Hollywood go-to rebound guy. Yeah, he's in everybody's DM right when it's okay.
He's right next door.
He's always next door, bro. Party is a creep.
I think she'd be called Girl Next Door. Next Door.
That was a terrible joke. Let's go to the next Ratchet News with that one. That was atrocious.
What's next?
Party, you gotta start getting some main squeezes. You a side nigga.
Oh, Gucci.
Whose father is that?
That's Gucci Mane. Ratchet news for 2 weeks now. Ever since he's been out of jail, that he's been cloned.
Free my nigga, grow.
Hey, is there any way we can pull up the old picture of Gucci Mane? What y'all think about this?
He just grew his hair.
He's just different, man.
You can ask you guys. One question you can see. Where's the ice cream tattoo?
So maybe he got it removed.
Tattoo remover.
Why is cloning the first thing you run to? He doesn't have a tattoo, he's been cloned.
So drastic.
I mean, he did go in looking like a fat ice cream man, and then he came out looking like he plays for the Falcons.
Man,
he looks like a wide receiver.
What else to do in jail, man?
I mean, he's definitely not cloned.
Let's just say he glowed up, man. He looks better than he used to be before.
But all these guys look different after jail, man. Ja Rule. Did you see how Ja Rule looked after jail?
Man. No.
What? You didn't see Ja Rule? Guys get out of the cell when they're
He's like The Rock, man.
He looks like The Rock.
When did Ja Rule go to jail? 2002?
No, man. This is 3 years back, man.
Oh, okay. Ja Rule's out here.
But you can see, though, I think
staying relevant. it's clear he's not a clone.
But a picture confirming that this is a real Gucci.
Of course, man. There's no way. Even the FBI or the CIA, they put out a statement saying that we haven't figured out cloning yet. So
they responded to
it's not possible.
That's
too drastic.
Yeah, who's gonna believe the CIA?
I know.
Get out of here. Let's go to the next one, man. Alright, man. When I heard this today, I was outraged and just hurt.
Before I even know the news, I'm like,
man, they saying that Jaden Smith is bi or gay, and he's in a relationship with Lil B.
Which, he could be bi.
What? Jaden Smith is not bi.
Okay, how would you know?
We don't know.
Will Smith.
Have you been with him in the same room?
Jaden Smith. How
look at those hair stands,
what's
bro.
In his head?
Yeah.
What's in his head?
But then, what's wrong with him being bi or gay?
I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with him, but Jaden's like a son to me. You know what I'm saying?
He's like a little brother
to me.
We get it.
I watched him grow up, man. You know what I'm saying? There's no way he's gay.
Calm down, Smith.
He's been holding it down. He's been trendsetting for years. I mean, he's been trendsetting his whole life. I can't see him pulling no stunt like that. And I read something on the internet. This is what they said that he said, which is a lie.
That Jaden said.
When Jaden said, when Jaden was asked what attracted him to the gangsta-licious-like rapper, he stated, "I was nervous at first, but he broke me right in, and now I love getting my pelvic bone pushed back. Thank you, Bass God."
What? He's gay. Uh-huh.
You think Jaden would say a statement? They're saying that he said that.
The statement is doctor, definitely.
Come on, this is stupid, man. Even the person who wrote this, you're stupid.
Would you dress like
this? This sounds stupid.
Would you dress like
I would wear that shirt? Yeah.
Would you wear
would you wear the flower? Head?
I wouldn't put that on my head. Yeah, but maybe he's on vacation, man.
Nah, vacation like this.
We could have got that. It could be in Miami, man. Look at the gesture.
He's like,
nah, man. He's like, yeah.
The pelvic.
He's
the
main wait. Let's do a BK. All
right, come on.
Let's do what?
No, okay.
Man, let's go to the next one. So we're gonna. Well, so you think he's bi? You think he's gay?
Okay, I don't know. I have to do my own research.
I think not.
I gotta do my own research.
Gonna do whatever he can do whatever he wants so long as his music is still awesome.
It's as long as his creativity stays dope. You know what I'm saying? Because he's a creative genius. But I don't think he's gay at all.
That's a shocker.
Lil Wayne, what's good with him and Ratchet?
Yeah. Weezy. So guys in the city, you guys know like on Sunday there was BET Awards, So Bonta say claims that Lil Wayne assaulted him when he was leaving like BET Awards.
What, did he punch him in the nuts?
I don't know, man. Maybe this guy, no, I did codeine, man. No, that is still a bro.
Man, where you got this off? Bossip.com,
man? Bossip.
Wait, where you stuff
all of
them
the 4-month news, bro. All right. So that's what Bonta said, man. Like, yo, Lil Wayne assaulted him when he was leaving the stage, you know, what part of the crowd. I'm like, what?
Is that a CC
bouncer? It wouldn't be
bouncer?
The first time, and it's not gonna be the last.
Yeah, it's gonna happen for Lil Wayne, man.
It's easy, man. Straight out of Holly Grove.
Yeah, man. It's gotta be next. Lil Wayne, baby.
Shout out Weezy, man. That's
shout out Lil Wayne. He's making his comeback heavy. Man, let's go to the next one. Yeah. Or is this the last Ratchet News? What? I think we got some more. Oh, man. Yo, this dude right here, his name, I hate this guy. I had to put him up here, man. I hate this guy's name is Rick Tyler. So let me tell you a little bit about Rick Tyler. He's a Tennessee 2016 Tennessee congressional candidate, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so for his campaign, he decided to put up a racist billboard saying "Make America White Again."
Like put up a billboard where?
Yeah, in Tennessee.
What?
Yeah, Tennessee.
Somewhere. Historically, it would be "Make America Indian Again."
That's historically,
that is the correct thing.
Cause
what?
Christopher Columbus ain't Indian.
I know.
The website.
He came there. He's an Indian.
I'm telling you. So there was
for more information.
So there was an outrage.
Why.info though?
For more information.
And
.info.
It's crazy, man. It's crazy. So I mean, it's just crazy to think that there's still people out here that are pushing this hard, this proud like this. And you know, of course the sign went down, and the current governor or congressman, I didn't know they even called him.
Is he still in the running after this?
Yeah, he's still in the running. But somebody else stepped up, and so hopefully he's not gonna win. But I just hate Ricky Tyler. I'm sorry, producers. Sorry, I hate Ricky Tyler. Anyways, did you guys hear that Stormzy's running for 2020? What do they call it?
Presidential?
Never.
You think Stormzy can run for president?
Like, damn.
He's running for 2020. What do they call it? It's like Pope? Not Pope.
No,
it's not governor. This is in the UK. Prime Minister.
Prime Minister.
Sorry. I mean, that was far out
there. Are you serious?
He's running for 2020 Prime Minister.
The Prime Minister just quit. Yeah?
He just quit.
David Cameron.
Yeah, so shout out to Stormzy. I think he'd be a great Prime Minister.
The focus guy doesn't come to industry, so
maybe to the youth. But what else could Stormzy do for
50 cents?
I mean, the youth is next.
Yeah.
Youth development, yes, but Stormzy.
Do you know 75% of Kenya's population is youth?
True.
Under the age of 30.
62% of the population in the world is youth, but still.
But still, the it's old Stormzy. People rule us.
But the old people rule us. It's our time as youth, man. It's our time.
The old people are just empowered. They're on the way out.
No, true.
It's our time.
Like all the major like decisions, all the big positions are by old
people. That's right now though.
It's our time.
That's our time, but then we're not making the decisions. That's what I'm saying.
But by 2020, we're gonna have a lot of power.
Yeah.
By 2020, we're gonna be grown ups. Like real grown ups. Like now we're like
we're grown ups, Barak. We're grown ups. I mean, really, Barak.
Like
speak for yourself.
I'm a grown up. I do grown things. For sure. But I'm like, I'm not a full grown adult. This is not what I'm gonna look like when I have a 10-year-old kid,
what you
okay?
Mean is that you don't
you think
have
I'm gonna look
kids.
Like this? Maybe you're like gonna you look like this when just... you have a 10-year-old kid. Hey, look, and now they're telling me they're gonna bring me a bib. Look, you need I'm gonna be a handsome, very handsome old man. But okay. I'm not an old man.
You know.
That's what
you're gonna
said.
Look like that when you have kids. I'm telling you.
I'm not gonna age. I'm not gonna age.
Yo, what's going on? And the BK, I know you got some ratchet news from Nairobi.
Okay, before
we
come down to Nairobi, our streets, yo, 50 Cent, bro. This guy, don't know. Every day, he always causes drama. Because he was arrested last Saturday.
He was performing at St. Kitts.
In
St. Kitts, the country.
Yeah.
For saying the word. Can you see that?
We're not in Kitts.
We're not in Kitts.
I was like, are we in St. Kitts or something?
I don't know.
So that's what. You know,
so are you not allowed to cast in St. Kitts?
Dude, we're in Caribbean country, bro. Like Caribbean country.
It's the Caribbean. I thought that was like near the Pope.
Caribbean
country.
It sounds like St.
Kitts. Wasn't more on 50 Cent, it was on St. Kitts and the people who organized that whole music festival.
Whole, you know.
Didn't they listen to 50 Cent's music, man?
I know, before
it's
you told
on
him to
YouTube,
come and perform.
Before you
they
asked him
got
to
Nick
come
Cannon.
To your country.
I know,
but you can't use indecent language, though. I mean, even though you're an artist, bro, you need to keep your
image
reputation.
You know, the thing is, when he first went there, he was just going to be a host. And then they're like, oh, dude, since you're here, then just like... give us some music. And then he used like the local DJ, and I was like, well, they should have checked his music if they didn't want him cussing.
Candy Shop and TIMP, there's so many great songs to choose from.
21 questions.
Yeah, like, I don't know what you heard about me.
Nairobi.
Hey, so anything happened crazy in Nairobi this weekend? I wasn't out too much. You know, I was being a good, but my mom's in town. Shout out to my mom.
Shout out Barak's
mom. She's in the city, so I've been hanging out with her. So I've been staying out of trouble, guys.
254, man. I don't know what's going on, bro.
Nothing really. We've just been kicking it, man. Nothing ratchet.
Hey,
when you go out in Nairobi, like, come on, things are ratchet.
When does thing happen? When is something ratchet?
Yo, there's nothing ratchet in Nairobi. What I can say, there's nothing ratchet in Nairobi. What I can say is there are so many summer bunnies.
Got the new imports coming in.
Got the new imports coming in, bro.
Yeah,
it's summertime. Summer 16.
Let's have.
All right, let's. We're gonna need to get BK some medicine.
I know.
To subside his testosterone. Yeah. Hey, so.
Clean.
Hey, this was Ratchet News. This was Ratchet BK. My name is Ratchet Jacuzzi. Ratchet Kalinga.
No, I'm not Ratchet.
And Ratchet
and Jerry.
And Ratchet and Jerry. AKA Cheesy Reezy. Yeah, you're not Ratchet at all. Cheesy Reezy. We still don't know why they call her that. Coming up.
Are you going to tell everyone?
Why they call me
Cheesy
Reezy?
Cheesy Reezy. Oh. Thinking Ritz Bits and Cheese. Cheesy Ricky. What's up? Tell me, why they call you Cheesy Ricky?
It's just a random nickname my friend used to call me.
Was his name Ricky?
No.
Did he make it real cheesy?
That was
no, I said all riches are cheesy.
Oh, sure you did. Anyways, hey, coming up next, we got my boy King Shukid coming through to bless the mic. He's going to tell us about his event coming down this weekend at The Alchemist. It's called It's About Time. And this is the Midnight Hump Show. Keep it cheesy, Ricky.
Come on, Ting. Oh, yeah. You know, they say that I need to post more, so I'm going to post more, damn it. What y'all laughing about is true. They want it fresh, unedited. This is fresh, unedited. No editing is going to be made to this video. I promise. Charlie Slim, tell me, how's your hump day going?
Nah, man, I'm feeling nice, man. I'm ready to hump it out here.
Oh, yeah, more juice. Ken, you already know.
Crazy, one of our leading editors. How you feeling this morning? Making a lot of more juice? He's going through a monk phase. No words, just... looks and cooks, baby. Whip it up. You know, it's the good house. Good people. Black don't crack. Oh, we have our leading social media specialist. He does absolutely nothing. BK, good to see you.
What do you know about someone 16? Really? You don't know if my nigga vibes can tell us straight out of Jamaica. Really, Gaza. Damn.
Nigga's lying.
Yes. Summer 16, really? With the vibes. Free the wild, bro.
You got that juice, I got that
juice. But I got no juice.
Yeah, yeah, you already know.
I'm the juice maker.
This is the good house. Did y'all see the Wiz Khalifa? And did you see the Wiz Khalifa and popcorn beef yesterday?
Yeah, I saw that shit.
Wiz Khalifa and popcorn, they beef at the Red Bull Culture Clash concert.
Damn.
What do you call it? Popcorn tried to say that Wiz Khalifa was whacked, and Wiz Khalifa came. Whacked. No.
Yeah, I'm a guy for the. I'm a Rastaman.
Pull it up. Like you definitely didn't see it.
Like, I saw that.
He is. Y'all some sons. Y'all look like rookies out here.
Gangsta, man.
Nah, like, he's tripping. Popcorn's dude, tripping. He called him Pop Tart. He said, "Hey, Pop Tart."
Pop Tart. You get
to that shit. It's crazy. Anyways, go check that out. You can't. I don't ever say Wiz Khalifa's trash, man. Here we are. We have Amelia. How's it doing?
Amelia, the good hair.
How the cabinets?
The cabinets. I'm just looking for
a cup. Word. Yeah, got a cup. You trying to get some juice out of that cup?
No, I just want some tea.
Okay. I thought you was looking for the juice. Okay, hide. All right. Like I said, it's Tuesday. You know the weather's a little bit gloomy, so you might want to bundle up. This is going online right now. Oh my goodness, we got such good people in the building. How's everybody doing?
Oh God.
Yeah, you already know. We got the editor's room, you know, we got Vincent, you know. Shout out my nigga Vincent.
The Vince Kahuna.
The Vince Kahuna, you better believe it. If you don't, you can't achieve it. We got Njeri over there on the left, right side, you know what I'm saying? Left, right. Like that YG song.
Oh, you have to
change myself? No, it's too dark. She is light-skinned, but under certain circumstances.
No, she is light-skinned.
She is. You know, it's just a wonderful day. You know, we got Aria back here, you know, playing some Drake, of course. You know, shout out to Drake. One dance. What's your name again? We met this morning.
Wendy.
Wendy. I love Wendy's. It's a great place. So, yeah. I'm just, you know.
That's what's happening.
Yeah, we need some internet, man. It's like the 80s in here.
80s?
Dang. Oh. We won Zuku.
Huh? No,
wait. That's a fire jacket. Like, I got that jacket at Toy, man.
Are you serious?
For sure, dog.
Damn, shout out to Toy.
It's so 90s.
Look like Tracksuit
like
Mafia, yeah?
Tracksuit
Mafia. hey, but let's get back to business. In the building right now, on Bless the Mic right now. I know you see him.
Yep.
You may have heard his... His dark, his deep voice,
man. The
late night special, King Shukid, man.
What's
good
really
to have
good,
you.
Good man.
To
what
have
is
you,
really
man.
Good. I'm
what
glad
up,
to
Shukid?
Be here, man.
How you doing, man? It's been a minute since you've been in the good house.
Good. I've been great. I just been in the studio cooking.
Cooking. Uh-huh. I see you. Never leave the house with it, without it. Too much to offer.
Always trapped. I'm
I've been
always
seeing
trapped.
This on my timeline for months now.
Yo, you guys better get your own copies
for
right now.
Months.
Can I have this one, man?
Yeah. Can you have it?
Can you?
It's happening.
Did you say happening?
What you mean have?
Hey, tell me, man. Too much to offer, bro. Why the title, dog? I mean, it's self-explanatory, but
yeah. I mean, before Too Much to Offer, I think I was doing a lot of rapping, and I was like a bit harder than I was in this one. I mixed it up. There's a hidden track. It's not even on the track list. Mm. If you get the CD, you'll know.
Well, if I have it, I'll let you guys know.
Yeah, so I was just trying to mix up a whole bunch of things, and like you said, it's self-explanatory. It's Too Much to Offer.
Joe, for sure. How's the feedback been? Like, you know, I know when some people change up the sound a little bit, sometimes fans, you know, are real vocal about if they liked it or not. How's the feedback been?
I think the Shukid fans been digging it. They've been feeling it. I haven't necessarily got anything. I haven't got any backlash,
word.
Per se, but people are digging it. The numbers is doing good. People copped it. No one's talking smack just
100.
Yet.
100.
I heard your music all the way in Canada, so you probably...
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How did you hear that? Tell me.
I want to know.
I heard it on... Was it HBR?
Oh.
They did a thing about, like... new rappers. Yeah, and then I heard it on there and I was like, ooh, YouTube that shit.
Yeah, like in 2015 I was amongst the freshmen. Maybe that's what you're talking about.
Yeah.
So that must have been it.
Yeah, but Shukid ain't no freshman though. He's been in the game for years. I mean, me and Shukid, we even met on the come up.
We went
years
way
ago.
Back from way back.
We had a record deal together.
Are you
serious? Yeah, we were signed to the same label, bro.
Right. Who are you, man? You got another life,
bro. I've been out here dropping bars, man.
Yeah.
Maybe I am a grown up.
Are you?
But he was in a group at that time.
Yeah,
he was in a group with Kevin Grant, Taffy, and
Capella.
Are you guys still tight, like Kevin Grant, Capella?
Kevin Grant's my producer.
Oh, he's your producer.
Yeah, so me and Kevin, the group split up. Uh-huh. And Cooler Gang, there's another part of the group that took the name Cooler Gang. By the time we were joining the same label, Cooler Gang had already split up. So even after that, the label thing didn't work out. So me and Kevin, we teamed up. He's a producer, rapper. I'm a rapper, co-producer. Uh-huh. And we teamed up together and we formed ID37.
Word. Yeah. I've been seeing the shirts. What does that stand for?
ID37. I mean, the first house we started making the music from. Was house number 37. People used to come through and just want to listen to the music and other things. So
I feel you. ID37.
Yeah.
It was then born. So this weekend, I know you got a show coming up. It's a real big show. I've been seeing it all over my timeline. I've been seeing it all over the internet.
Yeah.
Been hearing about it word of mouth. It's about time.
It's about time.
Tell me about it, bro.
It's going to be going down at the Alchemist in Westlands. It's
Saturday.
About time. It's just a bunch of young rappers that came together. You know, we were called up and we're like, yo, we need to do something for the young hip-hop in this country. Because, you know, we've been having people coming up, artists, DJs, presenters. They come up to us and tell us stuff like, I haven't heard any Kenyan hip-hop since Kalamashaka.
Oh. Ooh. Damn.
We just sit there like, I mean,
it's like, damn, you just skipped 20 years, bro.
Just like that. And people are dropping everything online on social media. Yeah. Even the charts have nice local music. Yeah, yeah. So I'm just, we just said it's about time.
Yeah.
We had to put the young rappers on the map.
Yeah, and the city's going to pull up. I can feel it, man. I can already tell from, the vibes that I'm getting that it's going to be quite an incredible event. So if you are in Westlands this Saturday night, pull up to the Alchemist. It's about time. It's going to be a lot of great performances. Tickets are only 500 bob at the gate. And it's going to be extremely lit. Shukid is going to be performing. But now before we get out of here, this is Bless the Mic, B.
Oh, I didn't get that memo.
This is Bless the Mic. Yo, DJ Echo.
Tell me.
Can you hit me with some beats, B?
Oh. I'm hitting you with it. It's gone.
You like this joint, dog? Can you make this twerk?
Man. Hold up. Let me hear it.
Okay. Welcome to the Six Spears of Cocos.
Okay. Listen, Shukid in the building. Yeah. Live legendary, 0 years in the penitentiary, to go unforgotten over a dozen centuries, packed to capacity with rhymes. I got audacity, harassing MCs, leaving wannabes in chastity, memory like a scientific gadget, rhyming ability, leaving allergies with niggas with rashes. I'm lashing till I make your heart start bypassing. Aha. Uh-huh.
Hey.
My bad, I lost it.
Bring us back. Hey, we good. We ain't gonna gas him out.
The mic is blessed.
Yeah, the mic has been blessed. The mic has been blessed. We gonna keep gonna let you kid leave with some gas in the tank. Hey, bro, it was so good to see you, man.
Thank
I can't
you,
wait
man.
To see you this weekend, bro.
For sure.
And we're gonna show you guys a video of another hip hop show that was at the Alchemist a couple months ago, starring myself and a couple other artists that are gonna be performing at the Alchemist this week. CZ, a lot of other people.
Man.
Who else is performing? It's a lot of people performing a lot of hip hop.
Papa Don, Ben Vic, Timmy Tim, Kevin Grant. I said CZ, right?
Yeah.
You said CZ.
I said Shukid.
Shukid.
This is definitely going to be.
It's the Don.
This is going to be an event to not miss. You don't want to miss this event. If you're really
like
into hip hop.
I don't know any of these people you guys are talking about.
And these are people that are out here too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They're just trying to pop that mainstream slot open. So you guys need to make sure to be there. This is the Midnight Hump Show. This is Shukid.
Before we go on a break, we have a very quizzical question we want to ask.
You got a question? What's your question?
The question is, what's the name of this sign?
That is a tic-tac-toe sign.
Count?
Yeah, it's a hashtag.
DJ?
Hashtag count?
I don't know. Hashtag?
Hashtag?
It's not an X and O, but it's
tic-tac pound.
Pound? Yeah, technically on Microsoft it's called pound.
What is it?
Are we right?
Are we going to find out later?
Man.
You got a secret?
Man, I'll tell you later.
Okay.
Chill.
Oh. Hey, and make sure you follow us on our social media networks. You know it's wg.live.tv on our what's good network.
I think you got it.
You hit it. Oh my goodness. Y'all got me confused. What's good on Facebook? What's good underscore live on Twitter? And what's good dot
WGLive.tv.
Yeah, WGLive.tv on Instagram.
How can we get this, man?
I
can't have it.
So, I have copies on me. They're only going for 100 shillings. I was doing deliveries. Like, whenever people in one area, I'm like, I'm hitting up Killer Lesher.
I'm definitely copying.
All my people.
That's a new idea. Yeah.
Are we allowed to, like, do transactions on...
I mean, are you buying something illegal? What do you mean?
As long as I get the money, it doesn't matter.
But you got an extra toy in here or something? Like, you should be scared. Make sure you go get King Shukid's.
Most definitely.
Too much to offer. He said there's even a surprise on this.
It's a surprise track on that. I don't know how you react, but it's just something little in there.
Fresh. Coming up next, we got the Party Calendar Boys keeping us updated with what's going on and what happened this previous weekend. This is the Midnight Hump Show. Go cop that King Shoe Kid TMTO.
Yeah. Hey. Hey. Yeah.
Okay.
Epity in the motherfucker. Woo. Hey. Woo. Skeng man run man down. Oi Rupert, shut your mouth. My semi GC house.
Bang, bang, bang. Oi, skeng man. Got my boy Semi TK. Oh shit, they got Big Mo as well.
Boots, you know what it is? Fresh new project from the Elite TNT. You know, we're killing the game.
Yeah,
all you rappers that's out there, you best know what's up.
You got Danger as well.
Yeah, what it is, yo. You know what time it is. It's Barrow's release party. Yeah, come fuck with us.
Skeng man run man down. Skeng man run man down. Oi Rupert, shut your mouth. My semi GC house. Oi skeng man run man down.
Mike BGS, right now I'm with 28, one of the sickest MCs right here coming out.
Nairobi. Yo, what's good Nairobi, man? It's your boy 28, shout out to Vice Life, what's good? Everything, man.
28, can you describe like your style of music?
Right now I'm just trying to do like music that really describes the kind of person I am, or rather I'm turning into. So there's a lot of like unanswered questions in the kind of music I'm doing. It can be seen in like the mixtape I'm putting out. I'm trying to put out a mixtape by the end of this year. The project is called Self. Yeah, man, and I guess the name is just basically self-explanatory, man. It's Self, it's about me, and yeah. That's what it is.
So who influences you?
Myself.
It's like wild out here for me, man.
Tell me something.
Lions, hyenas, bears, zebras, antelopes, cheetahs.
Wildlife. Oh yeah.
Wild shit.
Let's get it. What's good, people? It's your boy Mikey for WGS, and I'm with
Shapa.
Shapa Daga. You killed that performance, Shapa. How do you find the crowd?
Thank you. The crowd is dope, lovely, beautiful, chilling. Man, it's nice to see Mikey. You know I love my brother, man. Mikey got my back.
This is some love. Fun love as well.
Good. How are you?
So what? Any plans for the rest of the month?
Yeah, effing shit up.
I know you got many shows.
More music, more shows, more fun, more reality, man. We're just being ourselves and loving the shit.
That's dope, bro. Takes, what do you have to tell the fans?
I don't even need to tell anything to the fans. I'm just gonna say something to everyone. Keep the peace in your heart. Keep the love out of your mind. Keep the hate out of your mind. Just keep love with you, man. We're good. We're gonna be alright.
Last one. Any shout outs, bro?
Hi, mama. I love you.
Oh.
Hold it down.
This is up, man. Great. Shop, man.
Thank you, Mikey.
Yeah, man.
I go by the name of James Bond.
Yeah, my name is Kevin Obi.
Yeah, tell us.
Sorry, bro. Oh, sorry.
You don't see the thing. You don't see what's going on here.
Okay, have it
First
your way, son.
I come in here. He's sitting in my seat.
Yeah. No beef. No beef.
He knows I was sitting here, but you know, my name is BarakJacuzzi, the Coco Master.
And I'm Charlie Slim, Party Camp Squad, and Daniel Nyumba.
Yo, what a one.
Hey, what's up, DJ Echo?
DJ Echo still in the building. He's been holding us down the whole show. The whole show. Yeah, yeah. Shut up,
DJ Echo, man. Yo.
Kang, yo.
It's the Party Camp Squad. You know, we start by recapping the events that we hit over the weekend, you know, and seeing DJ Echo here. You know, this face, I've been seeing it in every party
the whole
I go.
Weekend, man.
We started at the Monster Party at the Giri, man. You guys, how was that party to you?
The location was dope.
Yeah, definitely.
The music was dope.
The girls,
we had a dope time. Yeah,
I just think it started off a bit slow, but it picked up during the end of the night.
Then finally we met DJ Echo once again at the Chemist, man, and he played a massive set. DJ Echo,
tell me,
how was your weekend, man? You've been everywhere.
My weekend was too lit. Too I swear. As lit. In, have you ever felt like the next day after you've been partying, you just feel like you don't know what to do with your life?
We've definitely had that feeling so many times.
It's almost like the world isn't the same anymore. It's like,
exactly.
Wow, the air is just.
Yo, Andeko, we've been seeing you out here like for the past couple of months. Yo, you've been playing almost
grinding
everywhere.
Yeah, man.
Wagwan, how has that been?
It's been great. Actually, you know, like the type of music that we are doing right now. Okay, it's not many people are getting it, but you know, we're trying to play a lot of places so that people know.
What type of music are you doing?
Yeah, I play bass type of music, Actually, people will say it's trap, but it's more bass.
It's more bass.
Okay. Now, as a young, you look like a fairly young DJ. Now, I know in the industry, and especially in Nairobi, even in Kenya, most of the DJs that are really out here every day spinning are some old DJs that we've seen since primary.
You know,
some kids. How is it coming up here in the coming up in the industry as a young DJ? You know, on the come up with the juice.
Okay, first of all, there's a challenger. I'm always frozen by the bouncers. They're like, hey, you're not of age.
Really?
But once you drop the bass, people are just like, okay.
I totally feel you on the age thing. Even when I'm hosting events, I got all the bands.
Yeah.
I still gotta be like, are you serious?
The tag and everything.
Crazy, man.
Yeah, man.
So what's coming up this weekend?
Yeah, still with Echo. You're on the bass things. Your Wagwanon's coming up. You were talking to me about something you are planning.
Okay, today. This week on Friday, the creatives, we are dropping out some chiller. Basma. The mood. Chill out.
That sounds nice.
Yeah, it's gonna be dope. I'm dropping a couple of ideas. Basma too. I don't know about the other DJs, but it's gonna be lit as usual.
G.I. Who's G.I.?
Yeah,
G of the DJ. I see Rake the artist. I see Sanctify to Oblivion. Imagine.
It looks like it's gonna be lit.
If you've never been to the Alchemist, it's definitely a groovy spot to go party at. You know, especially on a Friday.
Creatives too.
I meant creatives. My bad. It's definitely a groovy spot. Creatives.
Yeah.
It's definitely a groovy spot. Kilimani to go groove at.
Yeah. Entry free.
Yeah, man.
And free happy entry. Hour 5 to 7.
Five to seven.
We're gonna get happy.
Of course, we're gonna be there, man. But moving forward, man of them kibs. If you pull up the next poster, we have a lot happening this weekend, man. It's doing it's because it's about time.
Shukid just left the building. He's gonna be performing there. So many other great artists, especially hip hop heads. We're gonna be there. Holding it down. Well, I know I'm gonna be holding it down.
I'm gonna be there too. Yeah, definitely.
Okay, okay,
for sure.
Okay. Y'all in the building. And then we got what's the South African DJ?
Shimza.
But for Shimza,
it's next weekend, no?
Yeah.
It's not this weekend.
I'm excited.
But for future reference, that is.
But still, this weekend.
Always Temple, yo. Temple be going down on the 2nd. Yeah, on the 2nd, Rajel Ray, Eli Dev, and Alex W.
Yeah.
I've never been to Temple.
Oh.
I've heard about
it's lit.
I've heard it's very spiritual.
Some underground.
Underground
spiritual type stuff. Yeah, but for anybody who likes that kind of stuff, you can do it.
For sure.
Then we have Disco Boutique. The entries are G. It goes down on July 1st at the Alchemist, man, featuring Zelalem, Disco Vumbi, and Batida, man. It's going to be tant, man.
That looks like it's going to be
That's a nice
man, there's
line
so up. Many things
so
going
many things
on
popping
hey?
In
Juniper's Kitchen.
DFY, yo, big up to my boy Enchan and Salvation. I think this is like their fourth or third thing they're throwing down.
Yeah.
So come through, we show support to them boys.
And it's that silent disco,
silent
so a bit
disco.
Of
yeah.
And if you've never been to a silent disco, it's a disco where you wear
it's
headphones.
The bombs.
And it's crazy.
Bomb.
It's just a crazy experience.
Mostly the music that we playing out of the headphones is house and shit like that. But if you want to vibe, we have three channels to choose from.
Word. Word.
Yeah, man. And you know, as we always say it, man, if you have a turn up going down, holla at the heart, holla at your boys,
party
man.
Boys.
We're gonna come through. We're gonna pre turn up a good one and party with you. See you.
The best thing is to find us at the party, man.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Man.
Make sure you find us at your closest and local parties, even the ones that ain't local. We'll probably be there too. This is the party calendar. And if you need us to turn up your spot, hit us up. We're gonna come through, cover it, and we're gonna make it happen. This is the Midnight Hump Show. This was the party calendar.
Uh-huh.
Keep it locked. We coming back. Oh yeah. Modules.
This is Charles Slim reporting live at the Juniper's Kitchen for the party calendar.
Yo, I go by the name of James Bong as usual.
The lovely lady here.
Phoebe.
Yo, man, how you guys feeling?
Yeah, you're feeling good, yo. I'm glad. You're feeling so. We are turned, yo. We are turned.
What do you do, Tony?
I am a certified positive vibes lady. I like giving positive vibes every single day.
Where do you go partying? Let's start with that.
Juniper! For sure!
I was in such a good mood and then you guys came back in it.
Really?
Yeah.
I know you missed us.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah. The rat misses that dude. Nah. I didn't show you Miss BK. We was on a boat and I had to, and one of y'all had to drop. Like Echo, you good. Alright, but
okay, we're gonna drop.
You, man.
Why, man?
Man, first of all, because I'm going to want to kill myself anyways. You're going to be like, oh, it's so hot. You know me. I need sunscreen. I don't have a ton. Anyways.
Yo,
hey, I miss you guys a little bit. I ain't
going
to lie. So,
what's
we're
going
to play
on?
A quick little game, you know what I mean, called
Let's
Pick One.
Let's do it.
Yo, Keffa.
Hit us.
Hit him with the
Hit him with the foe.
Is this that? No.
Oh, snap. I forgot about these memes. Hold on. We're going to get to those. I was supposed to do those memes with the party boys, man.
What did I tell you about to do?
Hey, Ja Rule.
Stay relevant.
All right, so if you had to pick out of who's the, like, these are all out of musicians, rappers. Who would you pick between Ja Rule and Will Smith?
Of course, Ja Rule.
Will
which,
Smith!
Which century are we talking about?
I'm talking about, you got to pick if you just...
Like
you gotta
listen,
you gotta pick one.
No, like their music
from which century?
What do you mean?
From which decade?
We're not asking about the decade. I'm asking about the musician.
Because Will Smith was popping in the 80s, right?
80s.
But then his 2000 music was
how
like.
How old are you?
No, I listen to 80s music.
Who raised you?
Sing me one song
from the 80s.
That's so deep.
Please sing us
the
one song.
The days when he did before Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Like the kind of music. Was it 80s, 90s?
It was early 90s.
It was the heat is on.
So look.
Yeah.
I want to know who would you pick, okay, guys? It's not about when he put out music. It's about him together, all his music, collectively.
Ja Rule.
You gotta go for Ja Rule.
You're
Will,
gangsta, you know what I mean?
I think Will Smith is much cooler.
Nah, Ja Rule, bro, gangsta.
You're an awesome
everybody
idiot. Okay, you're smart.
Will Smith.
Summertime.
God, I do.
Right,
Ja Rule. Mother Inc, bro.
Next. Alright. Kanye or Jigga?
Okay, moods like Jigga. Kanye, but Memphis like, yo, be a gangsta.
Who
like
would
Jigga.
You pick, though? I honestly, I could go without Jigga.
I can too.
Me too.
But
but his lyrics are way more.
But Kanye's music is more entertaining. He's an entertainer.
I pick Kanye.
Kanye.
I can't pick Kanye because the latest video, if it was a video, famous video. That video.
Did you hear about it? Kanye, man. For those who don't know, in the video, he's laying in bed with Kylie Jenner.
You guy, bro.
And it's boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl,
Ray
boy,
J,
girl.
Bro,
yeah, he put like their own
Jenner.
You know when
they put
the video.
Chris Brown, Rihanna, John Legend, Bill Cosby.
Can I change my pick?
When I first watched the video, it was like the part where they're zooming across the bed, and I was like, "Oh, that's cool.
I didn't know what the video. I just
and then
saw the pictures.
We got
I'm
to
like,
Bill
nah.
Cosby. I was like, "What the
Bill
hell?
Yeah, Bill Cosby there. Yeah, no. Like when he threw Bill Cosby in there, I was like, "Wow.
Now, but you guys know Kanye. He's a controversial musician.
You have no
man.
Chill.
Everything is controversy with Kanye.
No
that's
chill,
so crazy.
That's what he wanted chill. From everyone.
Kanye,
your reaction.
I haven't even seen the video yet. I'm gonna have to probably get a title and go watch it. I swear.
It's supposed to be on Ratchet News number one. I don't know what I do.
Yeah, well, you shouldn't have been on Bossip, and if you wasn't on Bossip, you would have heard about his video. Next.
It's everywhere, bro.
So we all pick Kanye, right?
Jay-Z, bro.
All right, bet. Let's go to the next one. Pharrell or
oh
The Weeknd? That's
I
a tough one.
Both of these
That's
people.
Very easy, bro.
Pharrell.
That's, of course. That's
I
very
think Pharrell,
easy.
Yeah.
That's very easy. That's
hey,
very
Jerry,
but I love
man.
Both of these people.
If the woman said Pharrell, come on.
It is Pharrell.
Yeah,
it is Pharrell.
Pharrell, man.
What's your Pharrell, man? This guy's old, man. How old is he?
Pharrell, he's like 40 something.
Yeah,
40 something.
Yeah, this guy,
and
man,
that's
is old.
The same way
looks
he looked when
he looks young.
That's like what I'm gonna look like.
Man,
like that's how I'm gonna look like.
Face.
Black don't crack.
That's me. That's me in 40 in 20 years for sure. So Pharrell wins for sure.
Pharrell wins easily.
Next. Wiz or Young Thug?
Wiz, man.
Wiz.
Young Thug!
Are you serious?
Yes, this guy reads gang.
Young Thug.
This guy reads gang member.
I am so happy you guys brought this. Thank you
no,
so much.
No, man.
Thank you so much. Young
Wiz Khalifa.
Young Thug.
Bruh.
Why?
Let me tell you something. Okay.
Tell me.
Can I support my answer?
Please.
I don't understand.
Okay. Wiz Khalifa is like, he doesn't have to give you lyrics for you to listen to his music.
You
can
predict.
Like, and it's so...
But Young Thug gives you lyrics.
Do you listen to Young Thug? Do you listen to what he says?
I can't believe you listen to what he says. I can't believe you just supported your statement by saying that Young Thug.
Wiz has no content, bro.
No. I refuse.
Smoking the what on the plane. I got the money. Fuck my ex. Come on, man.
You're an idiot.
You're the idiot.
Hands down, Wiz.
Moderation, guys. Yo, moderation. Please.
No. I don't understand you, Kalinga. Because Wiz is smarter than any rapper
no
out there.
No way. Lil Wayne
like,
is the smartest
I'm
rapper.
Saying
Let's
like,
not go there.
Okay, you know what? Go for Wiz. Okay,
like,
can I support my answer too for Wiz Khalifa?
Yes.
This guy, man, he's a daddy, you know.
He's a genius.
He's a daddy.
Young Thug is a dad,
Young
too.
Yo, this
he's a dad, too.
Kalinga, first of all, his name is Young Thug.
It's okay. It's okay.
Lewis Kalinga Young Thug.
Kalinga, dog.
Really?
You totally just went down in all it's intelligent
like,
points.
It doesn't matter if I lost in here. Like, ask everybody, man. You guys, tweet us, man. Who's better,
like,
Young Thug or Wiz
IQ.
Khalifa?
Yeah, man. Let's ask
What's good underscore
Kalinga.
Life? Remember that. Let's see who is.
Who's
man.
Better? Who's
Kalinga.
Better? Wiz Khalifa Young Thug. That's such an easy question.
The content and everything.
People are watching this like, wow, he really is stupid.
Cabin fever. That's
like
long
our collective
ago,
IQ just Wiz. Dropped because of his choice.
I actually do not care.
next. Careful, man.
Your pages went down, bro.
Young Thug.
Oh,
I think that's it. That's it for pick one.
Yeah. I remember schooling you guys, who be those?
Oh, that's the freshman, 20XXL freshman 2016. I just wanted to get a picture of them. I wanted to ask you, kid, about these guys.
Damn.
Because this is the 2016 XXL freshman. We got Designer.
Yeah.
They got G Herbo. They got Kodak Black. They got Lil Uzi Vert. Don't know that guy. They got Denzel Curry. Lil Yachty,
Lil Dicky,
the candid white guy. He's the candid white guy. The producers are trying to remind me. I'm like, of course I know Lil Dicky.
Okay.
And they got Anderson .Paak. So this is a pretty straight lineup.
Okay, pick one then.
Like who I would pick.
Let's pick one.
I honestly,
who's the best freshman here?
Honestly, bro, Lil Dicky.
Lil Dicky.
Yeah.
BK.
Designer, bro.
Lyrically, she's coming, bro.
And Kodak Black. Kodak
Designer because
like,
of one song. Really.
No, new. Yo, there's a new mixtape. New English. Just like 5 or 2.
What's your favorite song off it?
Panda. Panda the new.
You just like putting my
I rest my
man.
Case.
I rest no, my case too.
I rest my case too. Somebody turn his mic off.
I'll go with Kodak Black.
Yeah, Kodak Black. Lockjaw. Who'd you go with?
I did, like I only know Panda and that guy from Panda and Dickie. So I wouldn't make a informed choice.
Word.
This is what smart people do, Kalinga.
I can't believe you said that. So tell me
yeah,
about this.
Yeah, our producer's gonna
yeah,
tell us what this
answer,
is called.
I think it's a tic-tac-toe board. It's a tic-tac-toe board.
It's a tic-tac-toe board or it's a hashtag?
Hashtag.
Oh.
Or
number. You millennials, man. You millennials, this is called a sharp in music.
Whoa.
It's
okay.
Oh, that's so deep, I mean.
Okay. It's a sharp.
Okay, you won.
Okay.
Tic-tac-toe boards have been out before sharps were made.
Yo, I know.
People have been
really?
Playing tic-tac-toe, okay?
Jerry does one.
Really?
So really want to talk historically.
Hashtag.
Well, historically, probably music was there before games. All right.
You didn't know? Did you know it was a what?
Yeah,
started music. Dog.
No, she didn't.
What is it? It's a sharp, a music sharp.
Okay, well, all our answers were right. Yeah.
All our answers were correct. That's yeah. one
but
way to look at it.
It's more than one thing. It's more than one
music,
thing.
We all
agree with the whoever in the room, right? We all agree with the whoever in the room.
All right, but anyways, I guess that's a sharp. A musical note.
We'll go with that. We'll go
That's
with that.
That's debatable.
We'll go with
we'll,
that.
We'll go with that. We'll go with that. Make sure you follow us on our motherboard at WGLive.TV. That is the What's Good Networks, where you'll find anything What's Good related. Yeah. And make sure you follow us on Twitter at What's Good_Live. And yeah. make sure you follow us on Facebook at What's Good Live. And make sure yeah. you follow us on Instagram. Anybody want to take it?
WGLive.TV.
Ooh, Snapchat.
What's Good Live.
Oh, yeah. And follow us on Snapchat. Our Snapchat is awesome. We also
it's
Snapchat.
Now.
You know what I mean? This was the Midnight Hump Show. I had a great time with these guys.
So did I.
Hey, shout out to Shukid. Make sure you go check out the concert this Saturday. Make sure you check out all the other events that we talked about on the party calendar.
Yeah, man.
DJ Echo, it was great having you, my dude.
Thank you, my
Let's
nigga.
Link up. Let's host and do mm-hmm. some shows together, man. I like how you spinning them things. No homo. This is the Midnight Hump Show. Make sure you hump something. We out of here. Oh, yeah. But Wiz Khalifa is definitely better than Young Thug. Like, let's get that out. Let's get that out the way, bro.